So, my friends, as you know, digital dharma, how to use AI to elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being, is coming out in September. In the meanwhile, I have launched digitaldeepak.ai to answer all your queries about anything that has to do with well-being, spirituality, theology, philosophy, etc. And as we move through the months ahead, I'm going to try my best to guide you how to best take advantage of digital dharma and how to best navigate digitaldeepak.ai. Now, I want to remind you that digitaldeepak.ai, you don't need to download an app. You can directly go to it through your browser, handheld device, computer, iPad, whatever. So, no need to download an app. The other thing, which I mentioned before, digitaldeepak.ai will not serve other, search engines. The content will be entirely mine and therefore, not subject to hallucinations. It will also clarify the various disputes that are happening in the understanding of consciousness and what my take is. As I mentioned, although there are philosophical and scientific models to explain consciousness, I believe that the only way to understand consciousness is through direct experience. In any case, today when I woke up, I remembered a particular quote from Sir John Eccles. Sir John Eccles was a neuroscientist who got the Nobel Prize just when I was about to enter medical school, mainly for his work on synapses and how they work in the brain. He was a student of Sherrington, who was one of the greatest neuroscientists ever. And so, this morning I woke up remembering a very famous quote from Sir John Eccles. And here's the quote. He says, Sir John Eccles, Nobel Prize winner in medicine and biology, I want you to know that there are no colors in the real world. There are no fragrances in the real world. There's no beauty and there's no ugliness. Out there, beyond the limits of our perceptual apparatus, is the erratically ambiguous and ceaselessly flowing quantum soup. And we are almost like magicians in that the very act of perception, that in the very act of perception, we take that quantum soup and convert it into the experience of material reality in our ordinary, everyday, waking state of consciousness. So, this is a beautiful quote, and I've used it a lot over the years, but I want to expand on it a little bit further. Okay, so Sir John Eccles, the Nobel Prize-winning neurophysiologist, implies a profound perspective on the nature of reality and quantum perception. I'll tell you later where I agree and where I don't agree. But here are the main points to understand from John Eccles. First, subjective experience. Eccles suggests that qualities like color, fragrance, beauty, and ugliness do not have inherent independent existence in what we call the external world. Rather, they are constructs of our perception and consciousness. That's amazing. So, the colors you see behind me, and the difference between this and this, these colors that you see are not inherent, have no inherent existence in the so-called physical world. Okay, then he goes on to talk about quantum reality. His quote posits that the underlying reality of the universe is a quantum soup. a complex, ambiguous, and ever-changing state that exists beyond our direct sensory perception. And he talks about perceptual creation. Eccles likens human perception to a form of quote-unquote magic, where our brains actively construct, he says brains, but it's not true. It is the mind that actively constructs our experience reality from the underlying quantum phenomenon. He also suggests and highlights the idea that our sensory apparatus has inherent limits, and what we perceive as reality is fundamentally shaped by these limitations. Furthermore, he addresses the mind-body problem. His perspective touches on the philosophical question of how our subjective experiences relate to the physical world, suggesting a complex relationship between consciousness and our material reality. His view challenges our intuitive understanding of reality, suggesting that our everyday experiences are more akin to mental construction than a direct representation of an objective external world. So his theories basically have been referred to as dualist interactionist theory of mind and brain. Okay, while I think this is a major, major advance in our basically abandoning the naive realism of mainstream scientists, I would say that John Eccles' view is still incomplete. And the reason I would say this is that he still believes in the brain as a material entity, even though he says, you know, no aspect of experience is material. He still believes in the material entity, and this view that he has is a dualistic view. It's called Eccles' dualistic interactionist theory. So what's the difference between what he's saying and what I have been positing as consciousness-only monism or non-dual reality? What's the difference between Eccles' theory? And later I will also share with you what's the difference between Bernardo Kastrup's analytic mind, cosmic mind, analytic theories of non-duality. Bernardo Kastrup's ideas are very close to non-duality. He calls it analytic idealism. I was thinking what the right word. He calls it analytic idealism. What's the difference between that and, you know, as non-duality and as understood in Eastern wisdom traditions, which is direct experience? I'll come to that. But for now, here are some key differences between Eccles' dualistic interactionist theory and non-dual understandings. So Eccles points a dualistic view with separate mental and physical substances that interact. Eastern non-dual philosophies and experience generally see reality as fundamentally unified, with apparent duality as an illusion. Then in the mind-body relationship, Eccles proposes the mind and brain are distinct but causally interact. The non-dual traditions often view mind and body as different aspects and expressions of a single underlying reality, modifications of pure consciousness. Eccles believed in a non-material self-conscious mind separate from the brain, but Eastern philosophies see the individual self as ultimately illusory, with consciousness as the fundamental ground of being. Eccles argued for a top-down causation from mind to brain. Non-dual views often emphasize non-dual causality or interdependent co-arising. Eccles attempted to reconcile dualism with neuroscience. Eastern traditions typically rely on a more contemplative practices and direct experience as understanding fundamental reality. Eccles drew from Western philosophical dualism, like Descartes. Non-dual philosophers emerged from Eastern metaphysical frameworks. Eccles saw consciousness as an independent entity interacting with the physical world, but Eastern traditions view consciousness as the fundamental nature of reality itself. While both challenged materialism, Eccles maintained a dualistic framework, whereas Eastern non-dual philosophies posit an underlying unity of all phenomena, including that which we call mind and matter. Okay, so that's the difference between Sir John Eccles' understanding and what I'm calling non-dual monism, consciousness-only monism. So from a scientific perspective, your body and the material world are proportionately as void as intergalactic space. If you could see it as it really is, the body and the world, according to the scientific model, you'd see a few huge emptiness and a few scattered dots and spots, some random electrical discharges, which are basically photons, okay, or quanta. Quanta. I'm saying that that's a model. If you close your eyes and experience your body, you don't experience a physical body. You experience an emptiness with a few scattered sensations here and there, amorphous, intermittent. These sensations are the real reality. Consciousness modifying itself as sensations, sensory experience. The modeling of that is quantum reality, the quantum body. But the quantum body is not fundamental. It is the consciousness body which is fundamental. So I hope this is helpful when I clarify it more. And once again, if you use digitaldeepak.ai and you don't understand anything, then you can pose questions on these videos on digitaldeepak.ai. Sometimes you'll get a response, be patient, I'm still in training. And we look at all those questions that you pose that don't give you a response. And those are very important for us. So let us know. Keep giving us feedback as we improve digitaldeepak.ai. I'll do another video on the difference between analytic idealism and consciousness-only monism as understood in non-dual traditions. Thank you.